Well, Black Friday, believe it or not, is 4 days away, and holiday shopping season kicks in after that.
Putting some thought into having a simple strategy for holiday purchases can save your wallet and your stress level. Our consuming happiness expert, Dr. Christine Whelan from the UW School of Human Ecology, is back with us to show us how. Hi, Christine.
Hi there. Good to see you.
This is such a great time of the year, but it is so stressful. And balancing this begins with asking yourself a couple important questions, right?
It really does. So before we head blindly into this holiday shopping season, before we sort of get caught up in all the pressure of, am I buying the right gift? Am I doing the right thing? I decided that everybody needs a manifesto to consume happiness this holiday season.
Sounds
right?
Great.
How can we consume happiness? That's what we really all want to do. I teach a class here at UW-Madison on that very topic. And so there are three questions that I think all of us should ask ourselves before we head out into the stores.
Okay.
First of all, what are our three core values? What matters most to me? What do I care about most? And it doesn't have to be shopping or materials and related values. What are the things that really that matter most to me? Pick anything. Then what are the activities or types of things that bring me joy? Not things that I have to do, things that I want to do that energize me and bring me joy.
If shopping's on the top of that list.
That's okay, too.
Okay.
I have no restrictions on this. We
but
just want to think about it.
You want people to actually write these down.
I actually want people to write these down, to give themselves the time and the space to ask these questions and then to write them down. So first, three core values, then what brings you joy. And then the third question is, who are the people or the groups that you want to make a positive impact on? Who do you want to support this holiday season? So after you ask those three questions, and then you can put like three down in each category, then I'm encouraging people to put together what I call this consuming happiness manifesto, where you say that you want to use your time and your talent and your treasure in keeping with your values so that you can spend more time doing more of these things that bring you joy, so that you can have a positive impact on the people and the groups that you care about most. And this is a way for us to think about what matters most to us and prioritize our spending, whether it's in terms of our time or in terms of our money, in keeping with the things that we care about heading into the holidays.
So this isn't a way to come up with a shopping list.
No, no, no. And yet, it can educate your shopping list, though, right? Because if you think, oh, there's a big sale going on, you can say, fine, is this spending in keeping with my value? Is this item going to bring me joy? Is it going to buy me time to do more of the things that I love? Or can I have this shopping experience with the people that I care most about? Right? So you think about it through various different lenses. Also, it's not just about shopping, right? Mm-hmm. You can spend time with your loved ones doing good in your community, whether it's doing a big leaf cleanup together as a community, spending time at a local volunteer organization. There are many ways that we can consume happiness without spending money.
Yeah, and it takes away a little bit of the commercialism of the holiday, too. It sort of reprioritizes what you should be thinking about,
true,
which is nice.
But let's be honest, there's a lot of shopping that's about to go on, right? And so because of that, I think that it's really important to think about how to spend money in a meaningful way, right? So buying experiences rather than things.
Oh, that's a good
spending
idea.
Money on memories. Those things last a lifetime rather than a gadget that gets worn out pretty quick.
Or donate to a charity in somebody's name?
Absolutely. These are things that make a lasting impact, and again, in keeping with your values. But unless we take the time to think about them, and not just think about them personally, but to share them. So I encourage everybody to fill out this manifesto, post it on Facebook, share it, go public with your opinions. Also, it can help those who are thinking about what the perfect gift for you might be. They see what you care about, the causes that you want to support. It's a win-win all around.
And here's where you can find it.
There you go.
Oh, and there it goes.
Oh, yeah. Hold it up, Christine, just for
a
second.
Oh, yes, I can. I will hold it up right here.
So in the blanks, you're just filling in the things that you value.
You fill in the things that you value right up here. So you fill in your values, and then you fill in the activities or things that bring you joy, and then also the people or the groups that you want to support most, right? And this is a way that we can all consume happiness this holiday season.
That's a great idea.
And you can find this online.
Yeah, you can find this online. I'm putting it up on my website. I think it'll be on your website as well, and on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter, and share widely.
Share.
Yeah.
Tis the season.
A Mad Lib with a purpose.
A Mad Lib with a consuming happiness purpose.
See,
very good.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Hey, to you
we'll
too.
Start there, okay?
Thank you very much.
Happy Thanksgiving. Great to see you.
Thanks. There's